एनसीईआरटी क्लास 6 लेसन नंबर 3 फाइबर टू फैब्रिक। फेहली एंड बुजो वन द फर्स्ट प्राइज इन अ साइंस क्विज कंपटीशन हेल्ड एट देयर स्कूल। दे वर वेरी एक्साइटेड एंड डिसाइडेड टू यूज द प्राइज मनी टू बाय क्लोथ्स फॉर देयर पेरेंट्स। When they saw a large variety of cloth material, they got confused. The shopkeeper explained that some cloths, he also had woolen mufflers and shawls. There were many silk saris as well. Pehli and Bujo felt very excited. They touched and felt these different fabrics. Finally, they bought a woolen muffler and cotton sari. After their visit to the cloth shop, Pehli and Bujo began to notice various fabrics in their surrounding. Children, here you can observe the picture of a cloth store. In a cloth shop, you will find variety of clothes. Different clothes are made up of different fabrics. When you feel and when you will touch, you will find the texture of different clothes. After their visit to a cloth shop, Pehli and Bujo began to notice various fabric in their surrounding. And then they found that bed sheets, blankets, curtains, tablecloths, towels and dusters were made from different kinds of fabric. Even the school bags and the gunny bags were made from some kind of fabric. They tried to identify this fabric as cotton, wool, silk or synthetic. Can you also identify some fabrics? Variety in fabrics. Activity 1. Visit a nearby tailoring shop. Collect cuttings of fabrics left over after stitching. Feel and touch each piece of fabric. Now try to label some of the fabric as cotton, silk, wool or synthetic. After asking for help from the tailor, do you wonder what these different fabrics are made of? When you look at any fabric, it seems a continuous piece. Now look at it closely. What do you notice? When you see a piece of fabric by a magnifying glass, you can find some patterns in that. Activity 2. Select a piece of cotton fabric you labeled in activity 1. Now try to find loose thread or yarn at one of the edge and pull it out. Piece of cloth, and if you find the edge, you can pull out the thread from a fabric like this. You can gently pull out one with a pin or a needle. We find that a fabric is made up of yarn arranged together. What are these yarns made up of? Fiber. Activity 3. Take out a yarn from a piece of cotton fabric. Place this piece of yarn on table. Now press one end of the yarn with your thumb. Scratch the other end of the yarn along its length with your nail, as shown in figure 3.4. You can see a thread, it has been scratched with your nail, okay? Do you find that at this end, the yarn splits up into a thin strand? You can observe here, or you can do it yourself. You might have observed something similar when you tried to thread a needle. Many a times, the end of the thread is separated into few thin strands. This makes it difficult to pass the thread through the eye of the needle. The thin strand of the thread that we see are made up of still thinner strands are called fibers. Fabrics are made up of yarns and yarns are further made up of fibers. Where do these fibers come from? Now let's see where this fiber comes from. There are different sources of fibers. The fibers of some fabrics such as cotton, jute, silk, wool are obtained from plants and animals. These are called natural fibers. Cotton and jute are the example of fibers obtained from plants. Wool and silk fibers are obtained from animals. Wool is obtained from the fleeces of sheep or goat. You must have seen a sheep. It has a very thick hair on its body, and from that we get fibers of wool. Okay, it is obtained from the hair of rabbits, yak and camels. Silk fibers is drawn from a cocoon of silkworm. For thousands of years, natural fibers were the only ones available for making fabric. In the last 100 years or so, fibers are also made from chemicals. Bujo has seen in the museum items like the one shown here. These are worn by the warriors. He wants to know if these were made of some kind of fiber. Have you seen a warrior dress? Warrior dress is to protect a person while he is on the battlefield. Substances which are not obtained from plants or animal sources, these are called synthetic fiber. Some examples of synthetic fiber are polyester, nylon, acrylic. Now let's see for some plant fibers. How do we get from plants? Cotton. Have you ever made wicks for oil lamp? What do you use for making these wicks? This cotton wool is also used for filling mattresses, quilts or pillows. At home you must have pillows. Inside if you see, you will find cotton in it. Take some cotton wool, pull it apart and look at its edges. What do you observe? The small thin strands that you see are made up of cotton fibers. Where does this cotton wool come from? It is grown in the fields. Cotton plants are usually grown at places having black soil and warm climate. Can you name some states of a country where cotton is grown? The fruits of the cotton plant or cotton balls are about the size of a lemon. How big are they? The cotton balls are the size of lemon, okay? After maturing, the balls burst open and the seed covered with cotton fibers can be seen. See, this is a cotton plant, okay? It is a field of cotton plant. You can observe this picture, cotton balls here, okay? And these cotton balls have fine strands of fibers, okay? You can observe a cotton and pull out the fine fibers. Or have you ever seen a cotton field that is ready for picking? It looks like a field covered with snow. From these balls, cotton is usually picked by hand. Fibers are then separated from the seeds by combing. This process is called ginning of cotton. Ginning was traditionally done by hand. These days, machines are also used for ginning. See, you can observe a person ginning of cotton. Jute. Jute fiber is obtained from the stem of jute plant. It is cultivated during the rainy season. In India, jute is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. The jute plant is normally harvested when it is at flowering stage. The stems of the harvested plants are immersed in water for a few days. The stems rot and fibers are separated by hand. Observe the picture here. To make fabrics, all the fibers are first converted into yarns. How is it done? Now let's see the spinning of cotton yarn. Spinning cotton yarn. You can try making cotton yarn yourself. Activity 4. Hold some cotton wool in one hand. Pinch some cotton between your thumb and forefinger of the other hand. Now gently start pulling out the cotton while continuously twisting the fibers. Are you able to make a yarn? The process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. Children, observe in this picture. You have to hold a cotton in your forefinger and thumb and start. You have to twist and make a yarn. The process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. In this process, fibers from a mass of cotton wool are drawn out and twisted. This brings fibers together to form a yarn. A simple device used for spinning is a hand spindle, also called. Another hand operates device used for spinning is called charkha. Use of charkha was popularized by Mahatma Gandhi as a part of independence movement. He encouraged people to wear. He observed the picture of charkha. Okay. Clothes made of homespun yarn termed as khadi and shun imported cloth made in the mills of Britain. To popularize and promote khadi, the government of India instituted a body called Khadi and Village Industry Commission in 1956. Spinning of yarn on large scale is done with the help of spinning machine. After spinning yarns are used for making fabrics. Now we saw from fiber to yarn, how the fibers are twisted and made into yarn. Now from yarn we are going to see how the fabrics are made. 3.5 Yarn to fabric. There are many ways by which fabrics are made from yarns. The two main processes are weaving and knitting. Weaving. In activity 2, you might have noticed that a fabric is made up of two sets of yarns arranged together. The process of arranging two sets of yarn together to make a fabric is called weaving. Let us try to weave some paper strips. Take two sheets of paper of different color, cut the pieces of length and width of equal to 30 cm from each sheet. Now fold both the sheet into half on one sheet and draw lines as shown in the figure. You can observe here strip A and strip B. It is cut into fine strips, and in figure number C you can see how it is woven and make. In figure 3.12, weaving with paper strips, okay, and on the other as shown in figure 3.12B, cut the sheets along the dotted line and then unfold. Weave the strips one by one through the cuts of the sheet of paper as shown in figure C. Okay. And you can find in figure D that shows the pattern after weaving all the strips. Observe the picture of hand loom. Okay. In the similar manner, two sets of yarn are woven to make fabric. The yarn are much thinner than our paper strips, of course. Weaving of fabric is done on looms. This is a hand loom, okay? And the weaving of fabric is done by, you can observe in this picture. The looms are either hand operated or power operated. Now knitting. You must have seen your grandmother or your mother knitting some sweaters. Have you noticed how sweaters are knitted? In knitting, single yarn is used to make a piece of fabric. See, you can observe this picture. Have you ever pulled the yarn from one torn pair of socks? What happens? A single yarn gets pulled out continuously as the fabric gets unraveled. Socks and many other clothing items are made up of knitted fabric. Knitting is done by hand and also on machine. Paheli wants to know if you have seen any fabric that are made up of fibers on the outer covering of coconut. What are these fibers normally used for? Weaving and knitting are used for making different kinds of fabric. These fabrics are used for a variety of clothing items. History of clothing material. Have you ever wondered what materials people used in ancient times for clothes? It appears that in those times people used the bark and leaves of trees or animal skin and fur to cover themselves. After people began to settle in agricultural communities, they learned to weave twigs and grass into mats and baskets. Vines, animal fleece, hair were twisted together into a long strand. These were woven into fabrics. The earlier Indians wove fabrics out of cotton that grew in the regions near River Ganga. Flax is also a plant that gives natural fibers. In ancient Egypt, cotton as flax were cultivated near the River Nile and were used in making fabrics. In those days, stitching was not known. People simply draped the fabrics around different parts of their body. Many different ways of draping fabrics were used. With the invention of sewing needles, people started stitching fabrics to make clothes. Stitched clothes have now gone through many variations since the invention. But is it not amazing that even today sari, dhoti, lungi, turban is used as an unstitched piece of fabric? Just as they were in large variety in the food eaten all over country, a large variety exists also in fabrics and cotton and clothing items. Now children, what we have learned from here: cotton rolls, ginning is done, it's made into cotton balls. After ginning, it is made into fibers, and after spinning, it is yarn. And yarn can be weaved or knitted. So knitting can be done or weaving can be done, and you get a fabric. This is cotton. Observe when you pull this, the fine fibers in the cotton.
Jute.
Okay. Jute we get from jute plant. Observe, this is an example of silk. This is wool. Wool we get from animal source, that is sheep.